everyone, it's Roseanne. Okay, I was asked if I could please do a tutorial on how I made my Tussie Mussies. And this is one that I have just completed. I was going to make another one last night. And then I had started making one. And then I got the email after the fact. So I have already made this one, but I am certainly able to make another one. They are very, very simple. So what I'm going to do is let me grab a piece of my chipboard, and there's going to be a lot of noise because I have the roofers are here, and they're tearing down the roof. So if you hear some loud pounding, and I'm sure hammering is going to start, they just finished tearing it down. By the way, everyone, if you haven't heard already, our house is under contract. Yay! But we still are having some showings, which is really odd. I guess they want to show the house in case there is, this one falls through, there's a backup offer possibly. So I'm still dealing with showings and cleaning twice a day. Yesterday I had a showing that was supposed to come, and they stood me up, so that was not fun. So anyway, what I use is, this is an 8.5 by 11 piece of cardstock. It's really thin, equivalent to, I would say, cereal box. This was given to me by my BFF Virginia Hy-Vee, and also she managed to find this big sheet of music paper. So this is what I use to cover my Tussie Mussies, and I'm going to just take, let me see, this one is already, just going to take a sheet that is two pieces of paper to do this, and then I'm going to see if I can't hurry up and do this. So what I try to do is hold the paper here, and then I want to start with the point and make a really nice point first, and then I'm just going to turn it or curl it, and it doesn't matter right now how skinny or how wide. I'm sorry, I have a mess here because I'm working on my junket tags that I'm involved in a swap in on Fun Crafts, My Fun Crafts. Anyway, so I just kind of train the paper a little bit, and don't worry about if it's straight or crooked, but the more important thing you want to do is make sure you have a point here. And then once I've got that, then I put my hand inside and I expand my fingers to make it the size that I want, still holding on to the base here so that you have your really nice sharp corner or your really sharp point. And see here, I've kind of separated the two. I don't want that. So what I want to do is bring the Tussie Mussie, this point, all the way to size it like that. And that's kind of how I measure, is how big I want the Tussie Mussie. And then I have already turned on my glue gun, so let's see if that works. And don't worry if it's not straight, if it's bent, it's okay. You can iron all of that out once you put the paper. So see, this is gonna be level here. And it doesn't really matter, it's just, it helps me figure out what size I want. It's kinda, you know, I don't know, wide enough so you can put some yummy goodness inside. Okay, so then I'm still holding, always holding on to here. I'm gonna bend this back a little bit, and I'm gonna start with gluing, and I'm just gonna go like this and put some glue in there and wrap it around, and then just hold it in place just for a little bit, and I'm just turning it so I can press it down, it stays evenly. And then here, to here, I'm going to put a little bit of glue also, but not until I cut it. So see how it kind of goes up here, kind of goes up. I just want to make it round, and it, again, don't worry about if it's straight. It doesn't matter. Just cut a piece off. See, it's all crooked. It's okay. So, I'm sorry for the noise again. Apologize, ladies. Okay, so there we go. Now, I have a little bit more room here that I can put some glue. And just putting the glue in there and smashing it down. And that's it. That is your Tussie Mussie. It is really super simple. And now all you have to do, see, you kept your point intact. And I leave a little bit of a hole because in case you might want to, at this point, if you wanted to put something through there, thread something, you can, because there's a little tiny hole in there. You could put a big knot and put your tassels or whatever, but I don't like to do that. I like to do that afterwards. So if you want, this would be the time to do whatever you're going to do there. And then I've got my paper here, my yummy vintage paper. I'm going to pull one off, and let me just see how much time I have. I don't know how much time. Oh, good golly, I didn't even turn on my timer. Okay, so again, I'm gonna do the very same thing, is I'm going to hold my paper and just hold it so I've got my corner here, and then I'm just gonna twist it. Just to train the paper, and then put your hands and kind of expand, still holding down here, expanding it a little bit, and then I want to test it and see, is that the right size? Yes. Okay, let's hold it. It's about the right size I need. And for this, I don't use the glue gun. I use the regular wet glue. And let's do this. And before I do this, I'm just putting glue there in the corner. And then I'm going to hold it here so it doesn't unravel itself. I'm going to stick it down in there as much as I can, and then I can open it up to the proper size. And see, it's all the way down in there. Here we can put some glue. Sorry again, guys, for the noise. Put some glue in there. And there we have it. Then all I do is, you can either do the outside and fold it in, or you can do the inside and fold it out. So this one, I'm just gonna put some slits in it here so it will bend back easily. And all I'm gonna do is add some glue. Doesn't need to be neat. You're gonna cover it up anyway, so don't worry too much. Don't worry too much at all. Sorry, I keep hitting the camera. So, just little bits at a time. There we go. Okay, if it's all rough and wrinkled, see that? It's okay, don't worry about it. It's gonna get covered up. And see, I made it a little bit too small here, but I ain't gonna worry about it. It's gonna get covered up. No one will know that you made it too small. See, and if it tears there, it's okay. It's okay. Because I have extra papers here, all you have to do is just cover up that little tear. Like so. Okay, so then we're gonna do the outside. Now that we have this pretty much covered, there we go. Let it dry a little bit. Okay, and we're gonna do the outside, and we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna make sure that we have it all covered up. And now this one, you're not gonna use your whole piece of paper. You can, I guess, if you wanted to, but, and I want this part to show. I don't know why, I'm gonna end up covering it anyway, but I'm going to let that part show, so. Well, I guess it's not gonna show, it's gonna be too long. So that's okay. There we go. And all you do is just get the glue started. Make sure it's covered all the way to the tip. And all I do, I'm sorry if I'm off camera here, is just put glue everywhere. Go ahead. Glue it down. Oops. Very nice. Very nice. And here you can do one of two things. You can fold it in, but I already folded the inside out. So all I'm gonna do is very carefully go around the outside. And I'm gonna cover it with lace and trim anyway, so it doesn't matter. As long as it's to the edge, it should be fine. And there we go. Put some glue there so it's nice. It's glued down. And there you have your Tussie Mussie. Really simple. You can go over this with Mod Podge and get it all nice and smooth, all the edges. I won't do that because it's boring. So yeah, there you go. You have your Tussie Mussie. I have my Glimmer Mist now. And to get it like that color, just spray on the inside everywhere. A nice portion, and then I just let it drip down in there. You can see it. I don't know if you can see it dripping down in there. Let's see. See it dripping down in there? There we go. And then it'll get all the way down to the bottom. And then you do the front here. That's why my hands are always brown on my nails. See that? How it gets in the nails. There we go. We have all this color here. And that is your Tussie Mussie, ladies. Now, if you wanted to leave it like this with the music paper and just put a few adornments or whatever, you could. Whatever you want to do. But there it is. There is your yummy Tussie Mussie. Okay. Stay tuned. I'm going to adorn it now. So stay tuned for part two. Bye, everyone. Love you guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all your wonderful comments. And I'll talk to you very soon. Bye.